Hey students, today I am going to start a new chapter, that is a 12th chapter, areas related to circles. Areas related to circles. After these circles chapters completed, you will learn some things related to circles. The name of the chapter is areas related to circles, means some parts of a circle already know, like segment, sector, those area of segment. Area of sector and area of circle, those we have to find in this chapter. So the name is areas related to circles. Before that, I will discuss some basics like perimeter of a circle and area of a circle. So what do you mean by perimeter of a circle? A circumference of a circle. Particularly for circle, we use the word circumference of a circle. Perimeter of a circle, a circumference of a circle is anything about the distance covered by traveling once around a circle is called its circumference. That is anything about one circumference, boundary of the circle gives us circumference of a circle or perimeter of the circle. So circumference of a circle is formula already know pi into d or 2 pi r, when d is diameter and r is radius of the circle. So their diameter is 2 times radius. This is r, r plus r gives us diameter. This total length is, this length is diameter. So diameter is equal to 2r. So usually we use the formula to find diameter or circumference of the circle is 2 pi r. One more, area of the circle is pi r square, where r is radius. Pi value sometimes will be considered as 3.14 and so on, or sometimes it will be considered as 22 divided by 7. So already you know, wherever pi occurs, then the value will be approximate, because this is not, we can't simplify this one. This is the pi value is not terminating, not repeating decimal expansion. So we can't say that is an accurate value, that is an approximate value. Okay. So when the number will be divisible by 22 by 7, so we will take 22 divided by 7, otherwise we will consider 3.14. So where pi will be there, that value will be approximate, that is not accurate value, because pi itself is a non-terminating, non-repeating, that is nothing but a irrational number. So wherever pi appears, the value is approximate. So you should remember these two by using these. And it's already know those. So by using these two formula, I'll start exercise. First exercise is very simple. Actually, areas related to circles, like area of sector, for example, if you have to draw here, you have to draw one line here. This portion gives us, this portion of the circle gives us what? Segment. This is what? Segment. So if you have to take this part, this is a sector. How to find area of the segment, area of the sector, we have to discuss after the first exercise. After the first exercise, we have to discuss segment, sector, these are parts of circle. So we have to discuss how to find areas related to circle, like area of the segment, area of sector, area of semicircle, how to find, we have to see after first exercise. Now discuss exercise 12.1 by using the previous formulas. The radii of two circles are 19 cm and 9 cm. The radii, plural form of radius. Radii of two circles are 19 cm and 9 cm respectively. Find the radius of the circle having circumference equal to the sum of the circumference of two circles. That means two circles are having radii 19 cm. This is one circle, this is second circle. By using the radius of the two circles are having circumference equal, means the circumference of this circle and this circle used and made one more new circle, the resulting circle. Okay? Sum of the circumference of two circles. What will be the radius of this circle you have to find? So let us consider this is R1, this is R2, this is R. Okay? Two circles are here. The radius of first circle is 19 cm and the second circle is 9 cm. The sum of circumference of circumference of these two circles is equal to the circumference of the third circle. Means, so cut these two and join these two, and you have to prepare one more new circle by using these two circumferences. What will be the radius of the resulting circle? This is the question. So let us consider the radius of first circle BR1, second circle BR2, and third our resulting circle B, capital R. So sir, let radius of first circle is R1, that is given here 19 cm, and the radius of second circle, that is R2, that is equal to 9 cm here, and the radius of third means resulting circle R, that is not given, we need to find R. It is given that sum of circumferences of these two circle is equal to circumference of the third circle. According to the question, circumference C1 plus C2 is equal to circumference of the third circle. That is nothing but what? 2 pi R1 plus 2 pi R2 is equal to 2 pi R. Why R1? Because radius of the first circle, radius of the second circle. Now, 2 pi, 2 pi. Take 2 pi common. 2 pi in these two terms you have to take common. R1 plus R2 is equal to 2 pi R. See, this 2 pi, will get cancelled because L is equal sign. R1 plus R2 is equal to capital R. R1 is 19 plus R2 is 9. That is equal to R. 19 plus 9 is nothing but what? R is equal to 28. Therefore, radius of the new circle is, radius of the new circle is 28 cm. Therefore, radius of the third circle or resulting circle is 28 cm. Sum of circumferences of these two circles will be equal to circumference of the third circle or resulting circle. So the radius of the third circle will be equal to 28 cm. I will discuss second question from exercise 12.1. The radii of two circles are 8 cm and 6 cm respectively. Find the radius of circle having area equal to the sum of the areas of two circles. Previous question was circumferences were equal. Here sum of areas of these two circles will be equal to the third circle. Means, so the radius of the first circle is 8 cm and the radius of the second circle is 6 cm. The area of these two, sum of these two circles is equal to area of the new circle, resulting circle. So what will be the radius of this circle? In the first case, circumference of sum of these two circles will be equal to the circumference of the third circle, resulting circle. But in this case, sum of areas of these two circles will be equal to the third circle. Is that the matter? We have to consider area in this case. Okay? Solution. Radius of the first circle is R1 is equal to 8 cm and the radius of the second circle, that is equal to R2 is equal to 6 cm. And let us consider radius of the third circle, which resulting circle is R. Okay. Now area of first circle is equal to 5 R1 square, and area of second circle is equal to 5 R2 square. Area of third circle is equal to 5 R square. According to the question, it is given that means sum of these two areas equal to the third circle area. That is nothing but what? 5 R1 square plus 5 R2 square is equal to pi r square. In this case, pi is common, so take pi common, r1 square plus r2 square. So r2 square is equal to pi r square. Pi pi get cancelled. R1 square plus r2 square is equal to r square. R1 value is substitute. 8 square plus 6 square is equal to r square. 8 square is 64 plus 36. This is equal to r square. 64 plus 36 is 100. That is equal to r square. So to find the value of r, therefore r is equal to 10 square root of both sides. R is equal to 100. That uses square root of 100 is 10 centimeter. Therefore, radius of the resulting circle or radius of the third circle is 10 centimeter. Therefore, radius of the third circle is equal to r, that is 10 centimeter according to the question. In this case, the areas are equal. Sum of the areas of these two circles is equal to the area of the third circle. Then the radius of the third circle will be 10 centimeter. So this is the way we have to find. Solution of the dear students. Now I'm going to discuss exercise 12.1, question number 3. In figure 12.3, depicts an archery target marked with its 5 scoring cards. It is given in the figure. Okay? 5 scoring regions. From the center, outwards as gold, red, blue, black, and white. So these are the colors. The diameter of the region representing gold score is 21 cm and each of the other bands is 10.5 cm wide. Find the area of each of the 5 scoring regions. See, here first gold, red, blue, black, and white. Actually, you made this width of each color is 10.5 cm and the diameter of the gold is given, that is 21 cm. See, once again, in figure number 3, that is an archery target marked with its 5 scoring regions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 scoring regions given here. From the center, outwards as gold, red, blue, black, and white. The diameter of regions representing gold score is diameter of the gold score is 21 cm. So diameter reduces off of that one. Okay? 21 cm. And each of the other bands is 10.5 cm. Means width of each band is 10.5 cm. Wide. Find the area of each of the 5 scoring regions. Means area of this region, this region, this region, all regions you have to find. One by one. From inner, from gold you have to come outside. It is very easy to find. Each scoring area, each scoring region. First, solution, diameter of gold region, let us consider the R1. So, this radius of this small circle is R1, next R2, R3, R4, and R5. Okay? So, radius of the gold region is 21 divided by 2. Why 21 by 2? Because diameter of the gold region is given, that is 21, that gives us 10.5 cm. Gold. After finding the radius, you can find easily area of the gold scoring region is equal to pi r1 square, because radius of the small circle considered r1. Pi value is 22 divided by 7 into r1 is 10.5 into 10.5 r1 square, so 2 times 7 1 is 7, 1.5 is 10.5. 22 into 1.5 into 10.5, you have to multiply and get about 346.5 cm square. This is the area of the gold scoring, means area of the small inner circle. Area of the circle uses 346.5 cm square. Similarly, we need to find the second circle, that is the red circle is the new one. This is small circle, this is the outer circle. Inner minus outer circle minus inner circle area uses the red color. So don't take directly this one. Only this part uses, this is a light green. Radius of the red scoring region is equal to R2, that is equal to C. This radius is 10.5, again width of each given, that is 10.5. 10.5 plus 10.5 gives us R2, you should consider, is equal to 21 cm. Means radius of the red circle or radius of the second circle gives us 21 cm. Therefore, the area of the red scoring region is equal to pi r2 square minus pi r1 square. That is equal to area of the outer circle minus area of the inner circle, that gives us the area of this path. Okay? Pi r2 square pi equal 21 into 21 minus r1 square pi r1 square, already we got, only to substitute directly on the right, 346.5, because already we found outside. 22 by 7 into 21 into 21, 7 also 73. 22 into 3 into 21 gives us 1386 minus this 346.5, subtract these two, it gives us 1039.5 cm square. This is the area of the second region, that is nothing but red region. Similarly, we have to continue. The radius of the blue scoring region R3 is equal to third circle is R3 is equal to radius of the second circle is 21 cm plus again 10.5, that gives us 21.5 cm, that is the R3 radius of the third circle or blue region. Now area of blue scoring region is equal to same again, this blue is the outer circle. After we found the area of the red circle, red region, so pi r3 square minus pi r2 square. So pi r3 22.7 into r3 is 31.5 into 31.5 minus pi r2 square, already we found that is 1386 for blue region. Up to here you can see this is second circle, this is the third circle. So you have to subtract, simplify this one, 74.5, 22 into 4.5 into 31.5, it gives us 3118.5 minus 1386. Subtract, it gives us 1732.5 cm square. This is the area of the blue scoring region. Now to point black up to year 1, next this is 10.5. That is important. Radius of black scoring region is equal to R4, that is equal to 10.5 plus 31.5, that gives us 42 cm. This is the radius of the fourth, that is nothing but black color region. So area of the black scoring region is equal to same pi R4 square minus pi R3 previous one, pi R3 square, that is equal to 22.7 into 42 into 42 minus pi R3 cube. Sorry, pi R3 square is already 3118.5. So 22 into 6 into 42 gives us 5544 minus 3118.5, that gives us 2425.5 cm square. This is the area of black scoring region. Next, last one, radius of white scoring region is R5 is equal to again same up to 42 plus 10.5, that gives us 52.5 cm, is the radius of the white last region. Therefore, area of the white scoring region is equal to pi r5 square minus pi r4 square. Similarly, same all. So 22.7 is 52.5 to 52.5 minus pi r4 square is 5544. 77.5 to 52.5. 22 into 7.5 into 52.5 gives us 8662.5 minus 5544. So finally it gives us 3118.5 cm square. These are the areas of the scoring slide: gold, red, blue, black and white. These are the 5 scoring regions. So bit confusion to find the second one is, so this is like green, pi r2 minus outer circle minus inner circle, outer circle minus inner circle, for all the cases you have to find, you will get area of the scoring regions. This is the solution of the third question.